to be seen in the house of God. Hallelujah. Like David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. It's good to have a house of the Lord that you can go to. Amen. And believe that God meets you there. Amen, somebody. Praise the Lord. He said he dwells in this place. I believe God dwells here. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Here's one thing I've been dealing with today. I've been praying about the spirit of heaviness today, and I'm going to stay in that vein today because the spirit of heaviness is something that we all have to deal with in our Christian life. And so oftentimes we find ourselves in a place of heaviness, a place of scorn, a place of self-condemnation, stress, depression. And it's in these times when we really need the body of Christ. You see, it's when your spirit is heavy that you need someone else that know the Lord to help lift that off of you. Amen. And so many people, you know, don't have that. So if you don't have someone that will come and intercede for you and help you get over your spirit of heaviness or even get pray that it be lifted off of you, then you can, you know, this is how people end up, you know, being always down. And even some people go on to commit suicide because of the spirit of heaviness. Okay? And we must understand that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, right? We're fighting against ancient demonic forces that have been here way before any of us, amen, were born. Are y'all with me? Amen. And their job is to possess, oppress the people of God, well, anybody, but most definitely coming after the people of God. This is what they are in the earth to do, to cause you pain and hurt and suffering. Amen. But thank God, the Lord Jesus said, but I am come that ye may have life and that ye may have it more abundantly. Amen. Praise the God. I was getting some people on social media asked to pray for them about heaviness. And I'm going to pray for us tonight because I know some of us in here experiencing some heaviness as well. And it's in those times that, like I said, we need someone else to help us lift it off. Kind of like with Saul. Some of us remember Saul. Saul was chosen by God to be king of Israel. But somewhere along the line, Saul decided that he wasn't going to obey the prophet, who was the mouthpiece of God. So in essence, he wasn't going to do what God said. So God rejected Saul. And in the scripture, it says, at first it says, and the spirit of the Lord came upon Saul. And that's when God had favored him. And then there came a time where the spirit of the Lord lifted off of Paul. And God sent a spirit to trouble him. I mean, let's read that. Let's go there and read that. Praise the Lord. Because see, sometimes we got to realize that sometimes the Lord sends. God sends trouble our way. Okay? If you don't obey, this is how God disciplines us a lot of times. It's by sending heaviness, sending a troubling spirit, trouble your spirit. If you God is like, you ain't going to do what I want, okay. You ain't going to do what you want neither. I'm finna trouble you. Come on, somebody. Amen. So go with me to 1 Samuel. 1 Samuel 11 and 6. I'm going to start there. 1 Samuel 11, verse 6. And the Spirit of God came upon Saul when he heard those tidings, and his anger was kindled greatly. Y'all see where the Spirit of the Lord came upon Saul. Now go to 1 Samuel 16 and 14. It says, but the Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul, and an evil spirit from who? From the Lord. Y'all see that? And an evil spirit from the Lord troubled him. And Saul's servant said unto him, behold now, 1 Samuel 16, 14, verse 15, and Saul's servant said unto him, behold now, an evil spirit from God troubleth thee. Y'all see that? So God will send trouble. He will send trouble your way. Are y'all still with me? See, all trouble ain't from the devil. Come on, somebody. Huh? See, God, see, we have to realize who God is. God is God. He controls everything. He gives Satan his boundaries, how far he can go and can't go. And if he desires to send an evil spirit, then God, I got to do is speak it, and the evil spirit will go, because he's God of everything. He's even over Satan. Come on, somebody. Huh? So we see here that Saul didn't obey, so God sent a spirit to trouble him. Now, let's keep reading. Verse 16. Let our Lord now command thy servants which are before thee to seek out a man. Somebody said, now he need help, right? Remember what I said earlier? When you get that spirit of heaviness on you, you need somebody else to come and help lift it off of you. Amen. Who is a cunning player of an heart, and it shall come to pass when the evil spirit from God is upon thee, that he shall play with his hand, and thou shalt be well. And Saul said unto his servant, provide me now a man that can play well, and bring him to me. Then answered one of the servants and said, behold, I have seen a son of Jesse, the Bethlehemite, that is cunning in playing, and a mighty valiant man, and a man of war, and prudent in matters, and a comely person, and the Lord is with him. Who is that? That's David. Somebody said that's David. Wherefore Saul sent messages unto Jesse and said, send me David thy son, which is with the sheep. And Jesse took an ass laden with bread and a bottle of wine and a kid, and sent them by David his son unto Saul. And David came to Saul and stood before him, and he loved him greatly, and he became his armor bearer. And Saul sent to Jesse, saying, let David, I pray thee, stand before me, for he hath found favor in my sight. And it came to pass, when the evil spirit from God was upon Saul, that David took an harp and played with his hand. So Saul was refreshed and was well, and the evil spirit departed from him. Amen. And as you go on down, I think around chapter 18, we find that the Spirit of the Lord, it keeps coming on Saul, and David has to play music to get him to lift up off of him. And there came a time about verse chapter 18 where the Spirit came upon Saul, and he began to prophesy. The scripture said that what he was saying was he was speaking out evil things, and he tried to kill David. This is when he turned against David, and he tried to kill David as David was beginning to play. Now, we know that Saul eventually went on, and this evil spirit troubled him the rest of his days, and he ended up being killed, trying to kill David. Amen. So sometimes the Lord sends trouble your way, and here's what we need to begin to do as Christians. We need to try the Spirit by the Spirit and see if it's of God. Are y'all with me? Most of us, I think, if you've been, have a relationship with the Lord for any length of time, there come a time when something happened and you'd be like, yeah, I know I had that coming. Amen, somebody. be like, yeah, that's just the Lord getting me. Come on, you know. And I didn't want no need to praying or nothing. That's just something that's just I have to endure because of something that I've done in the past. Amen. That's God spending a spirit to trouble your leg. There was occasion where even at the pool of Siloam, where they laid out in the porch, and the scripture said that once a year an angel would come and trouble the water. And whoever got in the water after the angel troubled the water, they would be healed. The first person again after the angel troubled the water, amen, they would be healed. And the Lord, I was meditating on that, and the Lord showed me that even, look, sometimes trouble can be a blessing. Are y'all still with me? Huh? See, sometimes trouble can be a blessing in disguise. Amen. Because we like to look at all trouble that comes our way as from the devil, but that's not so. We see here that sometimes God can send trouble. Are y'all with me? And sometimes I've noticed where God has sent trouble my way to keep me from doing something else. Amen, somebody. Mm-hmm. See, sometimes trouble is just to stall you so you don't end up going into something else that the enemy has planted and put out there for you. Are y'all still with me? Because God, if you got to believe that God can use anything, anybody, amen, to deliver you, to help you, to grow you, amen. If we really going to believe that all things really do work together for good, then sometimes we're going to have to take that trouble and be like, yeah, I don't quite know what it's for, but it's got to be working for my good. Are y'all still with me? Amen. Amen. So let's get back and look at the spirit of heaviness, because I believe this is what Paul had. He was always down in his spirit, okay? And I believe he was down because, not just because of the spirit, because he knew that God had rejected him. And amen. And so, you know, if you find out that, you know, God done rejected you, you know, your boss don't like you, you get fired from your job, whatever, you're going to feel bad about that. Amen. So he stayed heavy because he know he had messed up, he had disobeyed God. Now, one thing I want us to begin to look at, amen. Somebody want to say something? You had to come in. Amen. Praise the Lord. Okay. The spirit of heaviness. Let's read 1 Samuel 61. Let's go there now. 1 Samuel 61:1. Isaiah, I'm sorry, y'all. Yeah. Ain't that many in there, is it? Yeah, Isaiah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, y'all were looking for it though, weren't you? I said, Pastor says it's in there. I'm gonna look. Shoot, it ain't in my Bible. It's in yours. Isaiah 61:1. It says, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to them that are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord, and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all that mourn, to appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, to give unto them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness." Y'all see that? The garment of praise for the spirit of what? Heaviness. Heaviness. What God has given us right there is a key to the kingdom. Somebody say a key to the kingdom. He's given us how to get out of heaviness. What David, in essence, was doing was singing, doing praise and worship. And that's what lifted the spirit of Saul. Are y'all with me? And here right here, he said, he give you the garment of praise for the what? The spirit of heaviness. Amen. So you can't praise God and worship God and be sad at the same time. Somebody said, it's impossible. Amen. Now you can sing and be heavy. Come on, somebody. That's called the blues. Come on. Where y'all blues lovers at? Don't get holy on me up in here. That's called the blues. You know, woe is me, she done left me, and nobody love me but my mama and all that old kind of stuff. You can sing songs like that and be sad. And even get sadder, I believe. Come on, somebody. Yeah. But you can't praise God and be down in your spirit at the same time. It just can't happen. Amen. So right there, God gives us the prescription for the spirit of heaviness, and it's a praise. But somebody say but. But when you really stressed out, depressed, and troubled in your spirit, you really can't praise God. It's hard for you to praise God. Amen. That's why, just like Saul needed David, now you need somebody that will come and help you. Amen. Praise the Lord. I think every Christian ought to have that at least one or two songs that really, I don't care, you know, just really just, you know, like that's my song. You know, if you had a song in the world, you ought to at least have one in the church. Come on, somebody. Come on, man. Come on, y'all keep it weird with me now. Y'all know when y'all sang song came on in the world, man. If it wasn't crunk up, it's finna get crunk up now. Shoot, you ride with me, my song come on. Oops, we ain't talking no more. We gotta listen to this song right here, man. Amen. That's my song, man. And we be singing right along with them. Amen. Okay. So, just like we had a song that we identify with in the world, there ought to be a song, a praise and a worship song that just lifts you. I don't care what they play it, when you play it, you just love to hear that song. Amen. It takes you. And you know the music is a powerful thing, because sometimes we don't realize that music really takes us away from where we are. Amen. You can be frustrated, this, that, and the other, but for 3 minutes when that song playing, you ain't thinking about that. It has a way of taking you out of a situation, taking you somewhere else just for a little while. You got to come back now. But that's the power of praise, song, music. Are y'all with me? It's a beautiful thing, and it comes from God. That's why I can't understand these folk that don't believe in singing in church and stuff like that, and music. I just, you know, I can't grasp, because, you know, I've seen the power of music, you know, and what it does, how it soothes the soul. Amen. Now, you can pervert anything, mess anything up. Amen. But I believe music is a gift. Amen. Gift for the soul. Amen. So you don't need someone that can really sing when you got the spirit of heaviness. That's not what you really need. What you really need is somebody that is not heavy. You don't need two heavy folk, because y'all finna have a pity part. Come on, somebody. You need somebody that's up while you down. Y'all remember the law of the seesaw? When we talked about the law of the seesaw, sometimes up, sometimes down. Amen. You don't need nobody down, man. You know, I need somebody that's up to come lift me up. Amen. Praise the Lord. So once you get somebody that's up and somebody that you know has a relationship with God, now it's time to be honest and open. And here's the hard part about, you know, heaviness. Most times we don't really want to, how would I say this? We don't want to let everybody in on why we heavy. And I can understand that, to be reserved. You have to be careful who you tell your intimate personal business with. But if you're ever going to get delivered, you're going to have to trust somebody. Are y'all still with me? You can't trust everybody, but you're going to have to, at some point in your life, trust somebody to get delivered. Amen? So you're going to have to be able to be honest with yourself and then honest with this person that's going to help you. Are y'all with me? Because so oftentimes when people are not disingenuous with what's going on with them, what you find, what happens is that person that comes to help you, intercede for you, pray for you and all that, they can't get it all because you didn't tell it all. So you end up having residue left. Listen, are y'all still with me? So you never really get completely delivered. You feel better for a little while, but because that residue was left, then eventually that spirit just comes right back and begins to oppress you again. Amen? So it's best that we be honest, completely honest and transparent when we're dealing with something that needs some help. Amen? One thing I shared on Facebook today, and I really believe this to be true, is that I don't believe a believer can be possessed by an evil spirit. Okay? Because the Bible teaches us that once we receive and believe in Jesus, that we now have an indwelling Holy Spirit. Amen? And good and evil cannot stay in the same place. Okay? So if you've been born again, you have the Holy Spirit in you, then an evil spirit can't come in and possess you. I don't believe he can. But what he can do is oppress you. He can come upon you, apply pressure upon you. Are y'all with me? He can't get in you to control you, but he can cause you to feel a certain way. He can make you sick and all this kind of stuff, make you feel bad, have evil thoughts and evil dreams. And all. Are y'all still with me? Amen. So it's called oppression, not possession. Okay? Amen. And sometimes, and it manifests by being heavy and stressed out, depressed, and you know, confused. Amen. Confusion and not knowing what to do is one of the things that starts the stress process. Amen. When you don't know what to do, you know, you start stressing out. Amen. You know, so we're dealing with oppression. So stop thinking that you're possessed, because if you've been born again, you can't be possessed. Amen. He can't enter in, but he can influence you and make you heavy. Amen. Now, I've been praying today for some people on social media, but I want to pray for you all here that are experiencing some heaviness, because I believe that the Lord wants to lift it off of you. But here's the thing. I'm gonna need you. Those of you that's heavy, I'm going to need you to write down what you're dealing with. Why you heavy, what's been going on, how you been feeling. Just write down for me why. I got a pad up here and I got some pencils. Those of you, give them a white pad. Pass that around. Lady Ross, yeah, go around. You raise your hand. Lady Ross is going to bring you a piece of paper. If you just raise your hand and write down on there kind of what you're dealing with. Ain't nobody gonna see it but me. When you finish writing it, bring it to me. I want to pray about that heaviness on you. Amen. Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. here's the last tip for the night. God said he's given us a garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Okay? A garment means, it says something that you got to put on. See? You have to really put it on. You got to put it on and wear it like you wear clothes all day. You have to wear that praise all day. Are y'all still with me? You have to wear it all day. So we need to get you some praise music. Get you some praise music. I mean, get your favorite CDs or whatever, and just let that play all through the day. You know, when you're on your break, you can listen to it. Sometimes we can be at our desk and we can have our Bluetooth in and listen to music, whatever. But when you start to get heavy, use that key of the kingdom and just, you know, clothe yourself with praise. Just let that praise music get into your soul and into your spirit. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. Because sometimes we just going to experience times of heaviness. You know, I experience them. It's just part of life. Amen. Paul experienced times of heaviness. You read there's a lot of times, you know, when he was talking about, you know, he was stressing out about, you know, his infirmity. He said, I have this, you know, thorn in my flesh. He was frustrated. He said, you know, I've asked God to remove it 3 times, but he hasn't. Okay? And one time he told the church, he said, I will not come to you again in the spirit of heaviness. He said that. He said, I will not come unto you again with the spirit of heaviness. Amen. So even the man of God, I would even go so far to say even our Lord and Savior experienced some heaviness. And you know why he had to experience heaviness? Because he had to experience everything that we would experience. Are y'all still with me? So when he was in the Garden of Gethsemane, man, he was heavy. You know, he was heavy. The drops of blood was coming from his head. Come on, somebody. He was heavy, man. The devil was on him forever. You know, ever since he started his ministry, the devil had just been trying to kill him. Amen. So we all have to experience heaviness in times. Amen. And that prayer and that praise will do it. It will do it. Praise your way out, then pray and thank God that it is lifted in the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Father, we thank you today for this night. We thank you for the teaching. We even thank you, Lord, for the troubling spirits that you send unto us sometime. And we know sometime, God, we've given the devil credit for something that you've done in our life. And God, we pray in Jesus' name that you would give us a spirit of discernment, that we would be able to, God, know when it's you and receive it better, that for we can go through it and glean everything you have for us in the troubling times of our life. For we really believe, and we know this to be true, God, that trouble does not last always, and we know that every storm does come to pass. So we thank you, Lord. Even for the trouble that we're in now, the trouble that's going to come, hallelujah, we accept it, God, as being an issue of life, and we know that all things are working together for our good. So even though the spirit of heaven has come, even the spirit comes to trouble us at time, God, we will not be dismayed. We will not be defeated. We will continue to lift up our eyes toward the hills from which cometh our help, for we know that all of our help comes from you, God, in the name of Jesus. For all those that are experiencing heaviness, God, in the name of Jesus, we release the garment of praise to be upon them. Even those that are not here, God, but yet are experiencing heaviness for so many issues of life and sickness and disease and family issues, God, we pray in Jesus' name that you would allow the garment of praise to rest upon them and let them receive relief from the heavy spirit, God, from the stresses and the strain in the name of Jesus. And God, we thank you, Lord, that I was able to identify in the Spirit and the Holy Ghost, this spirit of heaviness, God, that I could help all those that have been reaching out and touching with me. So I touch and agree that they shall be delivered from this heaviness, God, in the name of Jesus. And we give you glory for it, and we give you thanks in the name of Jesus. Somebody say amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Glory to God. We thank God for tonight. Amen. All of you, we're going to close out tonight. And I'm going to continue to pray, amen, for the spirit of heaviness among you. Amen. And if something happens, you know, for the rest of the week, just send me a message, a text message or something, and get it to me, and amen, so I can pray about that. Amen. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. At this time, we're going to take up our offering, praise the Lord.